getting healthy. Rafael Marquez, Marcelo Gallardo apparently has the role with Didier Deschamps behind him. And of course, Didier Deschamps, remembering his first season, not just with Monaco, but really coaching. Tough spot to start your career, but if he settles in, the players certainly will go to respect someone they've seen play as recently as a year ago. Playing in the World Cup only 4 years ago. There is El Carcuri. The big news for PSG is Gabriel Heinze defensively unavailable. Their best player week in, week out, although he ended 2001 with a shocker, I thought, when he picked up the suspension he has to deal with now, the red card against Sochaux. He was not his usual self. This is Julian Rodriguez. Cyril Roule. Slipping in Gallardo. Gets the separation for a moment on Dehu. Nowhere to go. He's very quick. The man they call El Muñeco. Intercepted in the back by countryman Mauricio Pochettino. Of course, the doll. Some of these guys don't have the most intimidating nicknames coming out of Argentina. El Muñeco Gallardo. La Brujita, the little witch for Juan Sebastián Verón. Pochettino. Villiers. His leading goal scorer and pretty much the guy that has to have a big day, Shabani Nonda, the Congolese international, as we see Basque coach Luis Fernandez of Paris Saint-Germain. Of course, the commencement of the African Nations Cup on the minds of everyone. I think Luis Fernandez had the best quote coming up. So many coaches start worrying sick, in particular Arsene Wenger in the Premiership for Arsenal, who has a few African players. But Fernandez said, hey, we knew it was coming. We recruit heavily in Africa in this league, and that's the price we'll play in the middle of January. Leroy, who scored his first goal in the win over Sochaux, a bump from Rodriguez. And while we have a moment, take a look at the starting 11. Ooh, look at that. Of course, Luis Fernandez, your coach, Letizzi, the keeper, Potillon, Dehu, Cristobal, El Carcuri, Pochettino, all with defensive duties. Hugo Leal fills in, and Ronaldinho. Those two have to fill the shoes of Akocha, who's for Nigeria in the African Nation Cup. Up front, Ogbeche as well, the 17-year-old Monaco, Roma, Cubillier, Rodriguez, Marquez, and Roule. Switch player, Fenerut, Nyarko, Jugovic, Gallardo up front. Shabani Nonda and Suleiman Kamara, the 19-year-old Senegalese player, headed away in the back by Marquez. Hugo Leal gets this start in front of Arteta. I love saying that. Arteta unavailable for this one. Cyril Roule. Plays it into Nyarko. Paris Saint-Germain defending in blue. Frédéric Dehu, he returns to action, and just in time. We're at the Parc des Princes, not the most hospitable of homes. Paris Saint-Germain these days, Shabani Nonda is fouled, free kick for the visitors. Edouard Cissé. And now a cluster of players. I imagine it would eventually fall into the duty of Marcelo Gallardo, who, by the way, is still looking for his first goal of the season. This is the man that was the MVP of the league 2 years ago, and now his 13th appearance, zero goals. Ye also there. He backs away, leaving Gallardo. No, there's the dummy run straight on by Fenerut. Jugovic. Cornet. get a good chance to see what will be one of the anchors in that Argentine national team. You know, come World Cup time, the attackers will be on the spotlight. But the play of players like Pochettino, I think if Heinz, or I should say Walter Samuel, those two guys have to be flawless if Argentina's alone to get out of that group. This guy play a factor, probably not Gallardo. His role with Marquez, his role with Didier Deschamps could not have come at a worse time. If you want to get World Cup playing consideration, there's so many other good playmakers alongside you. Verón, Ortega, Riquelme, Aymar, now D'Alessandro. Once again in the mix, it's an incredible group. Cristobal, Jorginho. Who? And Eric Cubillier, 22-year-old winger from Nice, which is aside. Well, Ogbeche was supposed to go to the African Nations Cup, but he was on the roster, but not on the final roster. Here he is. Luis Fernandez tickled to have him about. 3 goals this season. And when he strikes that ball, he means it. Superb talent, really. Don't worry, he will turn 18 this month. See some gray hairs developing already. Meanwhile, he's going to get precious opportunity or experience with PSG in the lieu of countryman Okocha. There's a good run on the right side by Nonda. He's going to be doing all the work trying to connect Gallardo. Kamara has been set adrift up at the front. But Nonda, very good with ball on foot, gets a free kick. Should note he is a Congolese national, but was born in neighboring Burundi. Cyril Roule from Bujumbura in Burundi. Leroy wins the ball for the Parisians. Roule, Nonda, taken away by Hugo Leal. One and then promptly lost. Ogbeche. It's been a long time since the crowd here at the Parc des Princes has seen the home team score a goal, or any team for that matter. Jorginho, I believe, in an awkward fashion, asking for assistance from the sideline as he tumbled with Nonda. In the last 3 matches at home, Paris Saint-Germain have scored no goals. That includes the 0-0 result against Rangers, which saw them out of the UEFA Cup as well. I think Alex Nyarko's picked up the first booking of the match. Coming over for Everton, has made 14 appearances for Monaco. Free kick, the first this close. PSG, Ronaldinho's first attempt, headed away. Will he finally settle in? The fact he doesn't play every match leaves many scratching their head. Goulian, touched away by Nyarko. Potillon. Actually, I fed you some misinformation. It's actually the last 5 rounds at home PSG have not scored a goal. Flag is up on Suleiman Kamara. Nice touch, Cissé. Lovely run without the ball. Plays it across. Okbetje, but Cuvillier had the angle. Concedes a corner kick. Actually, there's an offside in advance of that. Oh! We may require your analysis test on that one on the linesman. That was dreadful. That replay apparently a mile onside. Unless my eyes are deceiving me. Marquez. Three games have been postponed so far due to freezing conditions in France. Long, the leaders, versus Metz. Sedan versus Auxerre. And Sunday's match, 2 days in advance, they called off the Troyes Marseille match. That was the match we were going to show you. However, Mother Nature has interrupted that. El Carcuri. Cristobal. With these missed matches, it kind of throws the league race in disarray, as now several teams have matches to make up. There is Didier Deschamps. As soon as they get a road victory, it's going to take a huge monkey off the back of that man. On the coaching front, a couple big moves in the offseason, or we shouldn't say moves. Well, Vigneux is out at Nantes, but Nantes off the bottom of the standings, finally, is Lorient now at the table, at the foot of the table. The other news is with Vahid Halihodzic, the head coach of Lille, had a skiing accident and is unavailable to make it to the matches. Word has it that he was going to call in instructions from the hospital to his second in command. Certainly from this point, you figure that Vahid Halihodzic relax and get over the accident. Hopefully it wasn't too serious. And then come when he's at full health. But for some, they can never rest. Gallardo, the target right behind him. It was better judged by Pochettino. Now Cisse. Cisse, dangerous ball in the midfield for Hugo Leal. One right back by Nonda. One back twice. Away from trouble. Lewa, a bit of a pest. Jugovic. Cisse. Nice work by the young Frenchman, Edouard Cisse, 23, ex of Rennes. Almost on his backside to do that. Quarter of an hour into this one, we are scoreless. To no one's surprise. And we're at the Parc des Princes. Something in my gut, though, just tells me today, fireworks. Who knows? That ball lifted by Rodriguez. Perhaps for Monaco, they've looked okay here in the opening minutes. Only getting the majority of the touches. Heat loses it. There's the late whistle. Advantage played. Free kick, Monaco. It was El Karkouri, the Moroccan. I didn't see much there that would warrant a second look, but Nonda certainly deserves it. Free kick from the far right side. Again, Gallardo. Straight in the middle. Not the best of clearances by Potillon, but it works out. Hugo Leal isolated, gives it away on that final touch to Rodriguez. Nonda. The big Ghanaian, Alex Nyarko. Kamara. Ogbeche. And one right back by Pontus van der Rood. Jugovic. Lewa very quick, but Rule just a bit quicker. Cyril Rule. Great left-footed talent. lackadaisical in the delivery, though. Very sharp. Here is Ladiziex of Metz. Top of the table with the match cancellations. Lawn did get their match in for round 19, but round 20 will require a makeup. Lyon, who knows? They have already had one match canceled. Auxerre had their last match canceled as well, so it'll be a while before we clear all that up. Good first touch by Ogbecha. He tried to cut in, but denied quickly. Julien Rodriguez. A man from Béziers. Good challenges, but Monaco conceding corner kicks. The fruitfully. Oh, Hugo Leal had a chance to make an indent. Now Nonda loses Leal momentarily. Camara, Gallardo, open goal, but bad angle. What speed, great ball back in. Camara unselfishly going to I don't know who. I imagine Fanarud, but he was about 10 yards away. Advantage played. Dehu, that's a great ball. Ooh, just a bit long for Ogbecha. Oh boy. I'm not sure if that occurred with a collision or he just was walking and something pulled. It looks like the way he is communicating with Laurent Duhamel that it was another late challenge. Rafael Marquez just returning from a long injury layoff and a pretty nasty challenge on the Achilles tendon. It says Arteta, that is Marquez in fact. He has gotten a yellow card. Ronaldinho's picked up two yellow cards on his opposition already. That's progress. Hugo Leal had a bloody nose for a moment. They're cleaning him up. The former player of Chivas, Guadalajara. Very rare that a Mexican player goes to Europe. It seems to be more in practice these days, not because of the quality of Mexican players, but because of the complex TV deals that are struck in that country where the TV companies own the teams, hence have a lot of money behind the whole football situation. But now with Marquez coming out and Cuauhtemoc Blanco, who helped permitting to have a huge impact for Valladolid and Mexico next summer. Valencia also at Espanyol, having his moments. Fanarud. Flag is up on Camara. Cristobal, 34-year-old Spanish midfielder. Lewa, Rul, very nice. Gallardo. Look at this! And a frozen defense of PSG for a moment. Great ball by Rule and great explosion by Gallardo. Jorginho. Rule. Nonda. It actually was Nyarko that time. Ogbecha spots something upfield. Hugo Leal lets it run. Jorginho. Cissé. This is great development. Lewa. Nah. What a cheeky little move there by Gallardo. All in the Kojak of the Seine. Those lollipops. Nonda. very fluid. Has time for the cross. Kamada! Handball, and Kamada might have got himself in more serious trouble. He has. Blatant disregard for the law. He's gone to the House of Pain. Yellow card. The first, actually the third now for Monaco. Kamada joins Marquez and Yarko. Another young man that wasn't called up for African Nations Cup duty. Doesn't bode well for his chance of making the World Cup squad, but obviously at his age, he's maybe looking for the next one. Senegal, hoping they're starting a new tradition of participation in the World Cup, same way Cameroon has. My goodness, Cameroon now, they'd make a bigger fuss if they didn't make the World Cup the way they're making it for Holland this year. Mourinho, Cristobal, sneaks through, nicely done, Ruhl. Marquez, Gallardo, they spread it. Cubillier, Rodriguez. Flag is up. A late flag, but Kamada offside for, by my count, the fourth time. And, ooh, it was close, though. But he was leaning the wrong way. If you want to win the referee's favor. Kamada. Ball intercepted by Jorginho. Betcha on the near side, if they can get it across, they have something. But now Monaco expands the defense. Cristobal. Hugo Leal. Nice ball for Cisse. They try to set up the Portuguese midfielder. Instead taken by Ñarko. Now Gallardo. Kamada. Haven't had goals, but it's been attractive first half with all the running. A lot of kids out there, and they are just expending themselves early on. Corner kick. That deflected off El Karkouri. This Gallardo's specialty. The set pieces. Heads to the near post, cuts back, Dehu clears. Kept in by Fannerud. Gallardo, short cross, skips through. Oh, it was Ñarko, who should have had the killer instinct. Trying to redirect it to Nonda, the cross by Ruhl. Incredibly gets across to Gallardo. Gallardo shot Letizzi. Took something off of this one. Look at that drop. Jorginho. Gugliel. He's right in front. Fannerud with his hand in the cookie jar. Fannerud made a big fuss this week that he wants to be part of the Swedish World Cup team. Why not? 21, though. May not be in the plans of Sweden side that should not be overlooked as a dark horse candidate to perhaps win the World Cup. And get out of that group again with England, Argentina, and Nigeria. The Swedes have proven that they are as good as anyone. More on that in a moment as Jorginho sets up the free kick. That is Dehu. And a free kick for Monaco. Remember, the Swedes demolished opposition in World Cup qualifying, where they left Turkey and other countries in their wake. And also, they beat England in that Euro 2000 qualifier, and they got through on that group first. So in qualifying, they have done very well. Euro 2000 performance, not so hot. But otherwise, Rodriguez, like a handball on Nonda. In the end, it comes down to Dehu. touched. Jugovic. Good effort here by Lewa. Perfectly legal play there. Gets through to Gallardo. Oh. Right in front of the PSG bench, and you could hear that one, and Gallardo did not like it. Watch it. Very late comes Lewa. Yeah, that should be a booking. Very careless. Not much, I wouldn't say malicious intent involved, but the end result, not pretty. Lewa hurt himself as well in the process. And he may be getting a yellow card, but as soon as he pops back to his feet. For Lewa, Dehu with that rotten look on his face. But his teammate should have been let off easier. In the life of a playmaker, you're going to get challenged like that a lot. Right in front of Didier Deschamps, you can see his reaction. Just remember Maradona, the amount of contact he took, and when you saw his ankles, they were inhuman, just massive from all the years of wear and tear. And through that process, he strengthened them. And the Wa really has done more damage in more ways than one. Like he might continue. Well, this team just sold Nicolas Anelka, and with J.J. Okocha, the forward situation has been thinned a little. Jorginho! Ofeche! Leon! All the youngins having a go! First, the 17-year-old. Then, the 21-year-old. Finally, Hugo Leao. Another 21-year-old. Siraru. Only in this league does 21 sound old. It's a good ball by Cristobal. Cisse. Yeah, there's a situation, there's a substitution in effect. Aloiso is going to come in for Lewa. Team that started in the forward situation with Laurent Robert and Nicolas Anelka. J.J. Okocha out of action, although he's more of a midfielder but can play up front. Aloiso is falling out of favor a bit. Chance to get right back in favor. Nonda before that. Yeah, something has to be done. I was going to say there's a lot of yellow cards, but the tackles are vicious. El Karkouri coming in. Three yellow cards for Monaco already, one for PSG, but the player who was booked is now out of the match due to injury. And could there be another one? The status of this match was uncertain until yesterday where they were going to play it. Kudos to the folks at the Parc de France and their heating system underneath the stadium. But Luis Fernandez said bluntly, I'd rather not play a game unless the conditions are 100% because you risk injury. And already that rings true, one of his own and perhaps one of the shops now unable to continue. The direct quote was, "I'd rather have the match canceled than play a bad game." And injuries, I think, fall into that. Suleiman Kamara. You feel for him. He gets a chance to play. And that does not look good now. El Karkouri becomes the fifth player booked in the match. I believe we are nowhere near seeing the end of that count. Cyril Ruhl, the face of Cristobal, Ruhl again, not to be confused with Fabien Kuhl. People had Auxerre, Ogbeche brought down. And there's this chorus of whistles every time there's a challenge now, almost anticipating a yellow card. And another stoppage, and Monsieur Laurent Dunamel already knows. Oh, good news certainly for Kamara as he comes back. It's going to be a tough day on the job. And I think that's what he's explaining. Was, unless you want a one-hour first half, these tackles have got to subside. So, captains Nonda and Dehu, part of the discussion. And I certainly applaud this because it has been not so good. Argentina. The reach of Aloisio. Banerut to Suleiman Kamara. Cristobal bailed out by El Karkouri. Monaco have it back. Gallardo. Flag is down. Oh! Just wide from Nonda. It rang the net, but it came from the wrong hole. That's just a glorious ball. Luis Fernandez has to be concerned that his team is making Monaco, a team who's obtained 1 point on the road so far this season, making them look pretty good. Hugo Leal. Too much on that one. Oh, Fanerud miraculously keeps it in play. Now it's out of play despite the efforts of Potillon, former Saint-Étienne midfielder. He plays on the left. Gallardo. Oh boy. That was going to be another booking there for Jorginho. And maybe it should have been. Took off a bit of skin, certainly. Hugo Leal. And another whistle was taken away from behind, but illegally. PSG with a chance right in front. José Aloisio, also formerly of Saint-Étienne. That team disbanded in the head of this season, its first year of relegation in some time. Oh, how the mighty have fallen. There's the stare of Didier Deschamps. Only 33, which means there's players on the pitch that are older than him. one up to Flavio Roma. Kamara, marked by El Karkouri, who also missed the African Nations Cup boat. Strange. Gallardo. Here's a good tackle by Cisse. That's his forte. Cristobal. Defensively, Sierra rule backs off. It allows Hugo Leal to sneak in there. An ambitious ball plucked out of there by Nyarko. Jugovic. Marquez. The deck right in front of Kamara. Marquez. Trouble there by Cuvillier. Ronaldinho. A mound of mankind developing right in front of the 18, and Sierra Rule and Ronaldinho. Boys! Line through for Pochettino. Now the counterattack. Rule. Look out. Nonda. Shabani Nonda with two players at the far post. Tries to use them. Intercepted by El Karkouri. Why are these strikers being so kind? Everyone dumping it off. Missing their target on the pass. Looked like Nonda had a good look at goal. The pass was always going to be chancy with the two defenders there. And the Keystone Cops then, and it got very seriously all of a sudden. The rites of passage. You see that Ronaldinho's gone to the Christophe Dugarry hair care. One bounce for Roma. That barrette, I think is what they call it. Cisse. Ronaldinho. Oh, look at that one. Uncorks it to Putillon. Here's the cross. Aloisio. Penalty kick. Perhaps the goal is imminent now. And the Parc des Princes in rapture. Yellow card. Cyril Roux for dissent. The cross by Potion, out of the reach of Aloisio. Oh. Did he ever have a chance at it? I don't think so. It was always going to be out of his reach. The tiniest of touches, Aloisio embellished. And there you have it. Well, almost 500 minutes have passed since the last goal by PSG at home. Their best chance to break that streak has arrived. It will be the Brazilian. Ronaldinho! Goal! PSG have scored at home! Rejoice! call Gilberto when you need him for a little soundtrack to the samba. He meant it. Roma gets drawn. Not all that high. And all of a sudden, it feels like a home pitch again. Because A, you get the call. And B, you get the goal at the other end. Camara, that one is blocked by Dehu. Played ahead by Ronaldinho, intercepted by Marquez. Camara coming back and he is fouled. Pochettino rushes it aside. Now it comes out to Cristobal. Ciraru with some work to do in front of Ogbeche. Jugovic. Hard challenge there. And a free kick for the Parisians as Aloisio, who's drawing everything. Oh, Marquez trying to displace a hip there. Only goal number 3 on the season for Ronaldinho. As we reach minute 45. Luis Fernandez beckons his team to move forward. Now they'll stand stationary. And we all know what that means. He has veto power over the captain as to who takes this. As Dehu backs away. You gotta love the young man. How can he walk the walk? Not a bad effort, but straight to Letizia. You notice how he tiptoed on his feet there as he approached that ball. Almost to not give the indication that he was coming to Flavio Roma. Two minutes. Nonda, the meat of the baguette there. He quickly receives the ball outside the 18, marked by Potillon, lifted up, Camara. Marquez was there, still alive and cooking. It's picked out by Gallardo. Rule, that was a sharp pass, second effort. Pinballed around, third effort, can it get through? No, El Carcuri, Aloisio. Rule. Ball is in play. Monaco, you sense, just a little bit unlucky in this first half. Maybe more than just a little bit. Jugovic. Rude flattens it out. Camara. Nonda. Carcuri doing the sweeping, ends up with Letizi. Almost expired the 2 minutes. Cisse, Hugo Leao, Cubillier. Well, well, well. A big 45 minutes coming up for PSG. They could get right back into the race. They have had no match. canceled due to the weather, and they won the first one where all the other matches were canceled in round 19, and on their way to making it 2-for-2. Lawn, who will not play, and now PSG will have a game in hand, could cut their lead to only 7 as we reach halftime. Again, the big news from Parc des Princes, PSG. Rodos, the champion from 98-99, Monaco. Take on the team that ruled the roost in the 90s for the most part, PSG. Champions in 93-94. Second place, 92-93, 95-96, 96-97, and 99-2000. So they did rule the roost, but only got one title to show. Some good runs in Europe as well. That ball by Cisse for Ogbeche. He hasn't been able to show too much of his wear. Rodriguez with a shocking clearance, but Botillon couldn't handle it. It was touched away by Coulier. Looking for Aloiso. That one, Cisse. Shot on goal. Roma. Brought down in the midfield by Dehu. Jorginho. Fanarut could not strip away from him. Dion. Teams remain unchanged from the half. There has been a substitution as Lewa was replaced by Aloiso due to injury midway through the first half. Jorginho with the free kick. Looks like he's going to the near post. He does. Over the head of Ogbeche, and Aloiso became the target, headed away by Cubillier. Ogbeche in there. Cisse. Flag is up. Kids. Jugovic. Deku. Luiso momentarily, now Shabani Nonda. Jorginho to the far side. Beche, his target left a bit short. He told you PSG is missing Akocha and Heinz. Monaco without Julie. Without Gael Givet, their star young defender. Bonal, Bierhoff also suffering injuries. And of course, as we've been reporting in the last few months, he can't seem to shake it. José Carril, Pierre Farfan continues to be on the injured list for Monaco. Jorginho. Heads away from the Lion's Den. The cross in! And Aloiso. Oh, it was a sitting chance. First, Ronaldinho had to avoid the toilet paper roll that was thrown out there. And then Aloiso came to get by Marquez, but played it wide of the near post. Nonda. Gallardo. Marquez. Get around. Rude. It's a good ball for Jugovic. Cleared away initially by Potion, the effort by Fadnerud. off target. Well, PSG parting ways with Nicolas Anelka. Worth noting that the winter market opened and will be open till January 31st. That man targeted, oh, he wanted Savio from Real Madrid. They were also talking about Santiago Solari. Later on, Luis Fernandez said one of those players he wasn't interested in, which probably took Scolari's name out of it. They couldn't deal on a transfer. Apparently, Jorge Valdano and Luis Fernandez met. Valdano wanted $18 million for Savio. Fanerud. Gallardo. Maybe his first touch of the second half. Can't get it through. The deflection ends up with Nyarko. Willier uncorks one, but it's blocked by Dehu, kept in by Fanerud. Three swings, three misses for Jugovic. Lajinha. He goes, but he doesn't have the angle. I tell you, Willier reads those angles very well. He's always seemingly in position, even here where he was flat-footed momentarily. Getting back to the Savio discussion, they asked Luis Fernandez if he was interested in anyone else in winter, and he goes, I've made my targets known. They didn't come through. I am not looking at anyone else. My roster is and will remain unchanged unless something changes with Real Madrid. But $18 million seems a bit much. Of course, Fulham spent, I think, $13.5 million to get John Carew. Somebody's money bag. Somebody's got piles over there. Piles of money. Here's a cross by Rune, but no problem for Letizzi. There's actually Jugovic with the cross. Cross, but he's going to get something out of it. So Pierre Lescure in the stands there. Bundled up. The president of the club. Finally. Gallardo. Marquez. And another corner kick. Marquez got a bit lucky there. Has the heir apparent to Mexican defensive football. Of course, the man there now, the Emperor, although he doesn't move as much as he used to, still as good as they come for a center back. Gallardo lobs it over to Marquez, and foul against the Mexican. This thing was formerly of Chivas. That is incorrect. He did play in Guadalajara, but for Atlas. So Guadalajara, you have Chivas, Tecos, and Atlas. Jorginho. Cissé. Potion. Good challenge there by Julian Rodriguez as Obeche retreated. Play. Things settling down somewhat since that very hairy first half. We saw seven yellows. Rodriguez. Flicked on by Gallardo. Now to Camara. Gets it over to Nonda. A bit too static, Monaco. Nonda held back by Dehu. Off his line comes Letizzi to take it. Look at this little touch. And Kamada received it, and his ball was pretty good, too. He put it over the defender to Nonda. gets. Quickly, let's give you the benches for today's match, as we may see the reserves in action shortly. We have seen Aloisio for PSG. Also on the benches, backup keeper Alonso, Franti Lazzea, Mendy and Agostinho. For Monaco, Biancarelli, Domeneu, Habitat, Platil and Eloire. Nyarko, Rule, Jugovic, can't get it by Pochettino. Well, now that we have his home form in order, at least for the time being, worth noting, although they lost, not including the match that ended up 0-0 with Rangers, that they ended up losing on penalties. The 9 matches since PSG have lost any match. With the, of course, not including that one, penalty kick. It is a loss. Played up across. Never really got enough towards Okbetche. Is up on Nonda. Of course, PSG fans are very familiar with their team starting to falter once the winter month begins. However, it seems like for the first time, winter has brought improvement in the side. In his last few matches, which has seen PSG going from mid-table to close to the top. As we said, they could go to third place for the time being. Fernandez said he gives credit to the training staff for keeping people in tip-top condition during the months where his little nagging injuries seem to accumulate. Oh, a hard ball in for Hugo Leal. Too hard. Flavio Roma. Fandiru doesn't have a very good match. That ball slips through by Aloisio. Rodriguez. Oh, that's nice. Now Aloisio has an angle. He's through the shot. Roma. Ex Piacenza, which is, of course, the stomping grounds of Dario Hubner. Explosive scoring forward. Jugovic to Gallardo. He was dispossessed. Cristobal. Cubillier. Wide open is Nonda. Gallardo keeps it coming to the left side, but Rule could not. Well, Jugovic could not get the touch in. His cross, Kamara. A lot of good work by Aloisio to eventually get open as Rodriguez was on top of it. Rather sporty. Jugovic. Gallardo giving the cushion. But way too far out. Where he might end up at Juventus. Becce is brought down. How about the crowd lobbing for that yellow card. Marquez is carrying a yellow. And that's certainly worthy of another one.
Well, no.
He got the ball first. We reach the hour mark. Ronaldinho whips it across. Then Jugovic and Van der Root combine to clear. Rule, his path obstructed. Not this time. Rule has it. Plenty of red and white jerseys coming into the picture now. If he can just get out of his cage. That's what Cisse embraces Rule. Gallardo pops a great ball in. Nonda gets by Dehu. Losing his footing is Aloiso. Vanderut. Nyarko. Gallardo. Pops into the air. There's players on the near side. Cuvillier. Patience from Monaco. And the shot into the waiting hands of Letizzi. A rocket off the left foot. Oh, there, Cuvillier. I like it. Cuvillier may be the best player on the pitch right now for Monaco. Look at that touch by Potillon. Finally denied by the hard-working Cyril Roux. Nyarko getting pulled around, but he's a tall order. Big, strong man. How he did end up on the Guinean side in the African Nations Cup. Another mystery. Gallardo draws in the defense. Can a teammate get to that one? They can. Gallardo again. Van der Root in a favorable spot. Gallardo. Shot blocked by Pochettino. Van der Root. Camara. Oh, goodness. Suleiman Camara. With a tremendous effort to equalize. Up. They had about 20 touches in there. This shot blocked. And who wants this more? Who wants it? I do, says Suleiman. And I'm only 19. Oh, courageous stuff. Off the traversa and in. Look at that smile. Look at the eyes. The coaching staff not as impressed. You gotta feel pretty good for that man, who because of injury gets the start today and gets his first goal of the season, first goal as a professional here at Monaco. First season since coming over from Africa. Aloiso! Hurrah! Roma! Oh, and wide from Aloiso, and Hurrah got in his way. Lines got crossed. What a great save by Roma. And right here, oh no! Business has picked up. On the target, headed away. I think Nyarko is down now. Counterattack, Cisse. Parts the defenders, it goes out of play, and now a moment to tend on Alex Nyarko. Monaco deserved the goal. In the midst fortune, misfortune.
Oh, another play.
Misfortune with the penalty kick and then some bad breaks going their way. But just like that, Kamada took advantage of a lackadaisical back line that just were not ferocious enough to win the ball back. Now Gallardo. Another nice one from him. Nonda. And a corner kick has been won there by Lee. Vivier. Yes. Monaco looking for more now. Remember, a tie is big news with their road form. Far post over everyone's head. They're out of route. Kamada! Oh. He gets a reprieve. Kamada! Out of play despite the sprint from Genio. Kamada got a bit greedy on that attempt at a volley that he missed badly. He's now becoming a bit of a nuisance. Go. Dice. Yep. Lost control for a moment. That allowed Cuvillier to clear it. Mendy. Multiple substitutions, it appears, for Luis Fernandez. Mendy is one. Javi Agostinho as well coming in. Botion has seen the end of his day. And Cristobal, the oldest member of the 11 up there, 68 minutes and no more. 24 coming in. French under 21. Mendy. A defender from Cat.
Okay,
played up. Agostinho. So, which was the fray? With that, PSG have now made their full allotment of substitutions. Monaco have yet to make one. The way they're playing, I doubt they'll be changed too much. Oh, Aloiso. Lazy. Dangerous ball by Cuvillier, but it gets through now. Marquez. By the way, a midfield. Beche showing his defense. defensive prowess, and like a traffic policeman, Fernandez waving him on. To maybe try making a decision there. Ogbeche. Hard ball for Mendy to handle. Corner kick. No. Getting over late there was Pontus van der Rup. Yugoslav and an Italian. Inter of Milan, eat your heart out. Gallardo. Can he finally loosen up the defense? Couldn't get it through as he was searching for Nonda, I presume. Cuvillier. Fandelut. Dehu. Noel Carcuri. Crossing over to put it away. Sounds like a French version of Flower of Scotland being sung. La 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 la. La 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 la. To think again. Great to pick up some of the songs that are sung in pitches worldwide. How about the Borussia Mönchengladbach version of You'll Never Walk Alone? It gives you goosebumps. Gallardo. Like a dive. And a genius with the long field to cover. Has Mendy to his right, Aloiso and Ogbeche in the mix. Van der Rood anticipated, read it well. Up it comes to Kamara, the goal scorer. That ball, the volley in Gallardo, slightly, maybe a little more than just slightly askew. PSG defenders looked back and could not believe that Gallardo had appeared unannounced. I gotta tell you, much more is expected from him, and that's what Letizia's saying. Somebody fell asleep. Seventy-fifth minute. There goes Stinho. Far post. Or Mendy surfaces. Mendy's fallen out of favor. That ball just started to elongate. And it gave Mendy a fighting chance. Disturbed his ball taken by Cisse. Cisse quickly hands it back to Cuvillier. Camara to deal with El Karkouri. El Karkouri almost loses it right back to Camara. Experience shining through there on Alginho. Alginho again, and that's a Greco-Roman takedown. Worth at least a point. And ooh, look at that scissor move. Nonda earlier into the handball, perhaps. No yellow card for Gallardo. Free kick for Juleal and company. Straight up ahead. Beche. Beche then commits the foul shortly thereafter on Juve. Duhamel conceded a questionable penalty kick. Had a busy first half where he showed several yellows. Second half has gone much smoother. Gallardo has, I don't know, missed the plot at times. Looked to be a cross out of the reach of Nonda. I'm not 100% convinced it was. They do get a corner kick out of this. But Gallardo, who's so quick, all of a sudden puts the brakes on instead of trying to make a run and maybe drawing a penalty kick inside the area. Redemption. Cisse. Take a look at the guy in the corner with the Manuel Petit ponytail. I think he may have been the halftime entertainment. Look at that. Gallardo a second time. In front of Angino clears the danger. Aloiso. Get the feeling maybe Monaco, although they're showing spirited run-ins to the PSG defense, would be happy with the point. Soon they only got 1 point previously. Nyarko. Oh, a lot of holding there of Nonda. Petizzi. Opeche. Aloiso couldn't get there in time. Cuvillier. Of coaches, those are the Championnat. No one gets younger than Deschamps at 33. Hernandez is playing days not that far back, 42. Oh, Cyril Innocenti. By Hugo Leão. He's been hot and cold today. Monaco have looked the more complete of the two. free kick. PSG, Hugo Leal, Ronaldinho still protesting. Nyarko had a good hold of him. Chitino. Down by Aloiso, then kicked away from behind by Rodriguez. Here's Nonda. May have overcooked that one. No, he hasn't. Gallardo. Two ways to go here. Takes it outside. He's in the 18. Gallardo. Nonda blocks in timely fashion by El Cacuri. That's what you want to see from Gallardo. Mendy. Leal, flag remains down for Aloiso, intercepted by Cyril Ruud. Less than 10 minutes to go. Camara. It all depends on how he brings it down. Not a bad way. Camara almost brought it out against Cisse. Starting from scratch, and Cisse now has the advantage. Edouard Cisse has looked very sharp. Sacrificing his body was Cuvillier. It may work out to Monaco's favor. Camara smartly goes to the experience. Gallardo. Nonda. Camara! Flag is up. He gives to the young man that time. He made an effort to get back onside. Almost did. Monaco just out of the relegation picture right now. Currently 13th out of 18 teams. 3 points out of the drop zone coming into this round. But I'll tell you, there's not much separating last place Lorient all the way up to 13th place Monaco. Monaco doesn't want to be sharing company with that group. There's a great run by Agostinho, finally cleared by Marquez. One too many defenders to deal with. Wagner Eloi. Reserve forward about to see some action for Monaco. It's going to be for Suleiman Camara. You got to like this switch because Camara played well after the goal. I think he may have gotten a couple delusions. Eloi, 28 years of age from Port-au-Prince. Of long. Aloiso. Obeche. Cisse. Now Pochettino. Gets the ball right back. Gives it away for a moment. Now Mendy. Ronaldinho. Obeche. Some work for Hugo Leal. Tries to smash it across. Fanerut. Eloi. Space for Gallardo. Shoots long distance again, wide of the far post. He gets a look from Nonda, and I think Gallardo was almost trying to say that he was drawing something up for him, but still, he looks for that first goal of the season. He had that I'm a big fan of Marcelo Gallardo, and I know he had that row with Didier Deschamps, but he has not looked all that impressive here. Far cry from the way he was wowing them 2 years ago in Monaco's championship season. Oh, Agostinho! Panarou, step for step, blocks the cross. Panarou's improved drastically as the match has worn on. Gallardo. Oh, he's got the wheels moving now. Eloy. Lovely touch. Not so lovely that time. Nonda. Eloy. Eloy. Finally stopped by Deku. And a goal kick. Ooh, how does that flash feel? Looks like it stings. Eloy. Panarut, no one chasing it, so he'll have the pick of the litter here. Volley blocked. Jugovic. Spurts from Monaco. Impressive defending, though. Not required Letizia to make all that many saves. Nocarcuri, Pochettino, Dehu, and Cisse. Collectively have been very good. Siraru. He's tripped by Cisse. There is our third man in the booth. Just kidding, I'm all by myself. I'm going to wear the Suleiman Kamara. That's very late. Certainly the booking variety. I think it was Cisse. Gallardo. Even last year, Gallardo produced 6 goals. It was a really gruesome season where they finished 11th. However, looking like it may get worse before it gets better. Cleared away in the back by Dehu. Beche. Powering through 2 tackles. Surprising there was no whistle. Narco there. Rule. Can he curl one? Onside. Nonda. What are you waiting for? To come off the boot. Gallardo goes short. Panarud, I don't think, was ready for it. Oh, Didier Deschamps is probably pulling hair out right now after what he just saw and what we all just saw. You're devising a play and you're not even ready for it. It shows you the lack of chemistry going on right now in this Monaco side. Not everyone on the same wavelength. Whether it can change, probably. Will it? Who knows? Trouble here, though. Offensive! Oh, Bartholomew. Still, you can see the beginning of something special in him. Remember the name. Panarut. Eloy. More sturdy defending from Dehu. Now, charging on the right side. Mendy! one get an Essendon jersey on him. Of course, making reference to Australian rules football, which you can also watch when in season on Fox Sports 1. All eyes turn to the fourth official. There's going to be a substitution, perhaps, for Nyarko. Abidal, a defender from Lyon. Dihu. Gallardo. Is it wide, denied by Hugo Leao. Panerut. Oh, lovely. Gallardo just needs a small window. And it's firmly shot. Into the second minute of stoppage time, almost about to get to the third. Root. Abidal. Root. No problem for Pochettino. Nor Letizzi. Did not see how much stoppage time. My guess is it's we're into the last minute of it here. It really was a half without incident, just the goal. Mike Kamara. Fanadur looked like David Beckham from the hair to the move and the skinny legs. And he's played like it in the second half. Out of play. Both teams looking for the 3 points. Okpeche, Marquez finds Nonda. Nonda cuts to the midfield. Lobs it over. Gallardo with some work to do. The shot! Oh my! Marcelo El Muñeco Gallardo with the stoppage time winner! Season for the Gallardo, and it's going to lead to their first away victory. What drama, only in Paris! What an amazing game. One swift moment when there was no chemistry. All of a sudden, it's galvanized. And Monaco have won.